Hi everyone, and welcome to another episode yet on my channel. Today we're talking about how to walk faster when using Blender. I will share features that I use every day and that help me to create arts and commercial work much faster. Blender is an amazing tool that has amazing features for artists, and it also has additional tools that significantly expand the potential of this program and give you the opportunity to walk faster. Today I will share features that I use in almost every project and which help me to walk faster. Everything that I will tell you is standard Blender features that you don't need using third-part plugins, add-ons, only Blender. So, let's go to watch this episode. The first things I will tell you is the set browser in a Blender. Everyone knows about it, but I still getting questions about how to use the set browser and especially how to prepare model to use them in the set browser. So, a set browser is a standard feature of Blender, which was released Blender 3.0 version, and I have to say that why I started using Blender instead of 3ds Max. It's quite convenient when you have all your models in one library and everything in one program. This allows you to quickly drop models straight into the scene. By the way, the asset browser is not only about models, you can also add here materials to create your library for faster use. In general, I advise to you always keep saving everything that you created in your library for future use. Making a cooler model, save it immediately to the asset browser as well as the material. It allows you to do everything faster in the future. So, how to prepare models for use in the asset browser? I open a new Blender file. Here I already have some models that I want to add to my library. First, if you have models consisting of many elements, such as this model from Kitbash 3D collection, which I used in the previous art. If you haven't seen this video, you can find the link here. So, in this case, I have to combine all elements into one geometry. I select all elements and press Ctrl-J. Then we have to check the origin of this geometry. That it must be in the center and bottom side of the bounding box of these objects. Because this object will be placed in the scene by this parameter when you get it from the asset browser, it's important. Next, we go to Outliner, find our object and mark as assets. After that, we find asset browser here, and here is my object, ready to use from asset browser. Oh, just one moment. You must press Ctrl-A and apply rotation and scale. It works correctly now. So then I do the same for another object in this scene. I want to combine this object into one. Do the same things that I've done for previous object, and don't forget to press Ctrl A, rotation and scale, and then mark as a set. So, if you want to save your time, you can add objects all together to the asset browser. I choose them all and add them as a set, and they appeared here. So, in one click, it's possible to add all models and save a little time. This applies to material as well. Find in the display mode and the file then materials, and choose some material which you want to add as a set into a set browser and mark as a set. It's important that everything works correctly. You can use all these assets in another project and add them to other file without any obstacles. You need to create a separate folder on your computer, laptop, or even external drive if you're working on different workstation at home and at work. So by using this way, it's possible to have one library and use it everywhere. Fortunately, Blender allows you to do it easily. So how to make this correctly? I open a new Blender file, go to the Edit Preferences, then File Passes. Here you have to add your new folder where you will save your all assets. Next, this file where I have a collection of models where I have saved them as assets. I store this file exactly in the folder that I have specified as the main section of asset browser in the preferences. So I need to save this file exactly in that folder, which I add here. So open asset browser and choose this Blender asset models, and as you see, all my assets models which I created here available in this new scene, and I can drag and drop and to my new scene all these models with textures and ready to use. It's important to understand that all your assets must be located in the same folder on the disk where you can specify the Blender from where you need to take these models. With asset browser in a Blender, you can add all your models in one library. By the way, in the asset browser, you can also have the opportunity to create a structure for all your models by adding subfolders and add models to it, and they will automatically restore to another Blender file. The second feature that significantly helps me in my work is a file browser. It makes it easy to see the texture and add them to the material without leaving the Blender. That's like an explorer on your system, but inside in a Blender. Unfortunately, this method has some restrictions, like it's not possible to open up a texture in high resolution, but it's still pretty convenient to work using it to find the necessary texture and drag and drop it to your shader editor. That's the Blender features that I use every day to speed up my work process. It's especially relevant for commercial projects where speed matters because your customer wants to get the result on time and you have to adjust to the terms. And using the library of materials and model will save your time. By the way, on the Blender market you can find many ready-to-use libraries such like Polyhaven asset browser. And also many artists sell their libraries, and you can accelerate your work by buying a couple of them. Today it's all. Subscribe to my channel if this video was useful for you, and leave comments if you have any questions. I also invite you to watch other videos on my channel, follow my social network, Patreon, all links in the description. And I will see you in the next video.